Hello everyone, my name is Dr. Murali Manohar, Chirumamilla. I am an Ayurvedic physician. In this program, I am going to talk about chronic worrying and what you can do about it. Well, do you constantly worry about everything and anything? This excessive worry does not just affect your mental health, it also can cause havoc on your physical well-being. Let me tell you the reasons for excessive worry and ways to break this cycle and regain your life happily. The most important point: who are the worriers? Why are some people so prone to worry? There are several reasons. There may be a genetic component. There are also nurture or non-nurture factors, brought up factors. For example, people who come from divorced homes are 70% more likely to have generalized anxiety disorder, which is characterized by chronic anxiety, exaggerated worry, and tension. Overprotective parents tend to raise worriers as well. Reverse parenting may also play a role. This occurs when the child is taking care of the parents because they are not functioning well. Then the most important point: what makes us worry? So now we know who worries, but why do they worry? People worry because they think something bad will happen or could happen, so they activate a hypervigilant strategy of worry and think that if I worry, I can prevent this bad thing from happening or catch it early. And if I don't worry, things might get out of hand. In this way, they think. The worrier's view is that if you can simply imagine something bad happening, it's your responsibility to worry about it. But all this worry can affect your physical as well as mental health. Worriers tend to be overutilizers of the healthcare system, meaning they see their doctor for just about every ache and pain. Worriers are more likely to have irritable bowel syndrome, nausea, fatigue, aches, and pains. In addition, 93% of people with generalized anxiety disorder also have an overlapping psychiatric disorder such as depression. Then the most important point: do you worry too much? Worrying does not always deserve such a bad blow. Sometimes worry is a good thing. If there is an actual threat, then there is something to worry about. Not worrying may be more of a problem than to worry. Then another important point. So how much worry is too much worry? It depends on the degree to which that disproportionate worry affects you, and how much you are suffering, and how much it limits you. If it is posing interference in your life, or is enough of a problem or nuisance that you are distressed, the good news is there is help. Now, the important thing: what are the steps that you can take? The first health tip: make a list of your worries. Identify what you are worried about. Next health tip: analyze the list. Look at whether your worry is productive or unproductive. A productive worry is one that you can do something about right now. For example, I am going to Delhi, so I may be worried about making plane and hotel reservations. This is a productive worry because I can take action now by going online to make reservations. By contrast, an unproductive worry is one which you can't do anything about. It is more of a proliferation of what ifs over which you have no control, and there is no productive action that will lead to a solution. For example, losing sleep and worrying about whether or not you will get cancer is unproductive. Next, accept uncertainty. Once you have isolated your unproductive worries, it's time to identify what you need to accept in order to get over them. You may need to accept your own limitations, or it may be a degree of uncertainty that you need to accept. For example, you may get cancer someday, as no one really knows what the future holds. Many worried people equate uncertainty with a bad outcome, but uncertainty is really neutral. When you accept uncertainty, you don't have to worry anymore. Acceptance means noticing that uncertainty exists and focusing on the things that you can control, enjoy, or appreciate. Next, bore yourself calm. Repeat a feared thought over and over, and it will become boring and will go away. If your fear is dying of cancer, look in the mirror and say, "I may die of cancer, I may die of cancer." Say it enough and it will lose its power. Next, make yourself uncomfortable. Worriers feel that they can't tolerate discomfort, but if you practice discomfort, you will achieve a lot more. The goal is to be able to do what you don't want to do, or things that make you uncomfortable. Worriers tend to avoid new things and situations that make them uncomfortable, such as parties or public speaking engagements. The preventative worry helps them avoid discomfort. But if you force yourself to do the very things that make you uncomfortable, you will depend less on the worry as coping strategy. Next, stop the clock. Worried people often have a sense of urgency. They think, "I need the answer right now, and if I don't get it, then something terrible will happen." Look at the advantages and disadvantages of the demanding such urgency. Rather than focus on sense of urgency, instead focus on what you observe right now. Ask yourself, "What can I do in the present moment to make my life more pleasant or meaningful?" You can either focus on getting an answer right now, or focus on improving the moment. The latter is better strategy. Take a deep breath, read or listen to music to stop the clock and limit your anxiety. Next, remember that it's never as bad as you think it will be. Anxiety or worry is all about anticipation. The what ifs are always much worse than how you feel when something actually happens. Worriers tend to worry about things that even if they happen, they can handle it. Worriers are actually good at handling real problems. Next, cry out loud. The emotional part of the brain, the amygdala, is suppressed when you worry. The emotion kicks in later with gastrointestinal symptoms, fatigue, or rapid heart rate. Use your emotions. Don't try to get rid of them, because when you are crying or when you are angry, you are not worried. Next thing, talk about it. Self-talk can help chronic worriers worry less by getting to the root of their issues. Each individual needs to understand what causes their anxiety or what it is related to. If you dig deep enough and go back to the early basis, it goes away because you have gotten to its roots. Next thing, take the herbal help. Instill 2 drops of tulsi juice as nasal drops in each nostril. Consume 1 teaspoon of Shankapushpi powder along with milk twice daily. Instill 2 drops of badam oil as nasal drops in each nostril twice daily. Consume ash gourd juice 20 ml per dose twice daily. Okay, this is the time to conclude. The tips and remedies that I have mentioned are all simple and common for all. However, if you are not relieved after using these remedies, you need to be examined by taking your pulse. You may need a personalized Ayurvedic prescription. Satam jiva sarado vardhamanah, satam hemantan satam vasantan. Live happily, keep smiling, be positive, try your best, keep loving yourself and others. Subham.